Hello and welcome to Storytime with Shivani. Today we are reading a short story from The Boy Who Wouldn't Bathe and Other Stories, written by Shivani Adeep. Today's story is called The Wise King. Raja Buddhi Pratap was a wise king who ruled over a prosperous land. His wisdom had earned him great fame, and people came from far and wide to have their disputes resolved in his court. One day, his friend Raja Veer Pratap, who ruled the neighboring kingdom, decided to pay Raja Buddhi Pratap a visit. Accompanied by a servant, Raja Veer Pratap reached Raja Buddhi Pratap's palace, where he received a warm welcome. Raja Veer Pratap sat in Raja Buddhi Pratap's court and observed the way the latter dealt with all the cases that were presented in court. He marveled at his friend's intelligence.
"There is no doubt," he thought to himself, "that Buddhi Pratap is very wise, but I would like to test him myself."
He called his servant and gave him certain instructions. That night, the two kings enjoyed a sumptuous feast with many delicacies prepared specially in honor of Raja Veer Pratap. After a hearty meal, Raja Veer Pratap suggested a stroll outside.
"It will help to digest this excellent meal, and I'll see something of your city," said Raja Veer Pratap.
They had barely started their walk when sounds of a distant ruckus reached their ears.
"Go and find out the cause of this hullabaloo," Raja Buddhi Pratap instructed a servant.
The servant raced ahead while the two kings followed at a more leisurely pace. The servant soon returned.
"Maharaj, two women are having a loud argument. Each accuses the other's son of stealing a silver amulet from her house."
"Let us go and see, Buddhi Pratap," said Raja Veer Pratap.
They reached the place where the two women were shouting at the top of their voices with a large crowd looking on. Opinions divided loudly in favor of one or the other. As the kings approached, the crowd fell silent.
"What is the matter? Why are you shouting so?"
asked Raja Buddhi Pratap of the women who were still quarreling. Seeing Raja Buddhi Pratap, the women stopped arguing and folded their hands.
"Namaskar, Maharaj," said one. "I am sorry for shouting, but it is this Lajavanti's fault. Her son Raghu stole a silver amulet from my house, and instead of apologizing, she is accusing my son."
"She is lying, Maharaj," said Lajavanti. "It is this Pulvanti's son Madhav who stole the silver amulet from my house. It was given to me by a holy man just a few months ago."
"Where is this silver amulet and when was it stolen?" asked Raja Buddhi Pratap.
Lajavanti handed the amulet to Raja Buddhi Pratap.
"It was just after dinner, Maharaj, some 15 minutes ago. I was washing up when Madhav came to borrow some milk. He must have pocketed it while my back was turned."
"She is lying, Maharaj," said Pulvanti at once. "It was Raghu who came to borrow some milk from my house and made off with my precious amulet, which was given to me and not to her by a holy man. He told me they were in the middle of dinner and his father was keen to have some almond milk, but there was no milk in the house."
Raja Buddhi Pratap examined the amulet while Raja Veer Pratap smiled into his moustache.
"Let's see how he solves this one," he thought to himself.
"What did you have for dinner?"
Raja Buddhi Pratap asked the two women.
"Puris with potatoes," said Lajavanti.
"Curd rice," said Pulvanti.
"Then Raghu is the one who picked up the amulet,"
said Raja Buddhi Pratap.
"How can you be so sure?"
asked Raja Veer Pratap in surprise.
"Feel the amulet, Veer Pratap. It is slightly greasy. Raghu was eating puris and gave his hands just a cursory wipe before going to borrow the milk. You are right, said Raja Veer Pratap.
But, said Raja Buddhi Pratap, Raghu did not really steal the amulet.
What do you mean?
You had a hand in this, my friend, said Raja Buddhi Pratap. I suspect you sent your servant to ask these people to enact the whole drama just to test me. Raja Veer Pratap looked sheepish.
You are quite right,
as usual. Forgive me, my friend. But how did you guess? The wise king smiled. It is very simple. When I examined the amulet closely, bringing it near my eyes, I got a faint whiff of the attar you use on your clothes. It was to you that the holy man gave this amulet, and you have, no doubt, been keeping it in your pocket.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to our channel by clicking on the subscribe button and notification bell below the video. Thank you for listening.